I'm Luke Banister.
I'm Brett Collis.
We fly drones, basically.
Yeah. Drone racing.
We're both part of a team, Tornado XBlades. It's a racing team. We all go to events and we do team events together, and it's just a group of the top European pilots.
Yeah, so taking it to the Americans, trying to beat them.
Well, Brett's trying to beat them. Yeah, I'm just here to have fun. I've always been interested in flying, and I flew remote control planes before this. And then when I saw a video of the drones on YouTube, I thought, I've got to try this. Got the gear for it, and it started from there.
Yeah, so similar to me, I've flown like planes, helicopters, boats, cars, so like radio control car racing before, and then kind of saw this on the internet and then got into it from that and just bought all the bits and built it up. So there's basically four angles of motion on the quadcopter. You've got kind of up and down altitude control, which is this stick here. This one here does kind of yaw, so left and right. And then here you've got roll, so right and left, and then kind of backwards and forwards, so front and back. And you kind of got to balance all of them, balance an active flight to get it to fly, basically.
We have a camera and it transmits back to our goggles, which is essentially two little screens inside of a, you know, plastic housing. With some lenses, so essentially makes it look like you're sitting in front of a big screen. At first it is a weird experience, but after a few flights you just get totally used to it, and it's just basically like sitting and stepping into the cockpit of it.
I think the pilots and all of us on the team love this kind of event because the track is quite routine. This is a complete different set of skills that you need. So we love this kind of challenge, and we think that the more we can develop this side of it, it'll be more interesting for the viewing public as well. I think this has definitely pushed the limits of the pilots. Luke Banister, Banny UK, is the world's number one, and even he's had a bit of a challenge with some of the things we had to do on this particular race.
Well, there's some tricky bits, like obviously the shot through the van is quite hard because you're turning. There's things that, whereas normally it's kind of one object that you can see the exit from, you're turning into something that you don't know it. And it's quite tricky with the height. Obviously outdoors you can go as high if you want if you make a mistake, but in here you hit the ceiling or something like that, kind of flying through smoke and whatnot. Yeah. Kind of veils the actual target that you're kind of aiming for.
Yeah, we had some mishaps.
Yeah, we had a few mishaps. GoPros scraping on the floor and bouncing around.
At least the Mustang's alright, it's all that matters.
Yeah, we didn't break any of the expensive stuff, it's fine.
So we have 36 GoPro cameras, they're all linked together, and what that creates is a bullet time moment, just like you've seen in The Matrix. Traditionally this is done with stills cameras, but we are using video cameras to allow us more control in post-production. It allows us to choose whatever moment we want at, from whatever angle. Our options are pretty much limitless, only constricted by the size of the GoPros.
I think my favourite car today is going to be the Focus RS after drifting in it. That was incredible. Mustang's cool, but nothing beats that.
Yeah, the same for me. I mean, just the fact that it has a drift mode button just says it all, doesn't it? You can't say no to that.
Next year, Ken Block, us versus you, drones versus RS, it's on.